do is to minimize this regarding the A electron. That's the last decision you have to make. How large this hexagon should be. Right? And this is a simple UQ type. If you have heard of UQ, it's basically this, you can take the derivative one. First order condition, solve the optimum A out of this. Very, very simple, close to it. Approximate, of course, I have to say. Oh no, this one is not approximate. I'm sorry. It's not approximate. This is for the homogeneous infinite. This is true, exactly true. Okay? Well, next thing, we're going to approximate. That's why I'm thinking about approximation. Okay. We solve the homogeneous case, but in the real world, very seldom we have homogeneous things. Okay? Things change over space. So what we do is to use the results in the previous slide, applying it to a general inhomogeneous case.
When you say homogeneous, you mean operand is homogeneous.
Yes.
So constant, lambda constant, f constant.
Yes. Yes. Sorry, if I didn't make it clear. Yeah, everything constant, every prime is constant over space. In order to solve more general cases, we apply the results we got just now, applied it to the more general case, finite area, and sort of a spatial varying cases. The basic assumption we have to make is that things are changing slowly over space. So approximately slowly, changing slowly over space. And then also the problem is large scale in the sense that S is really large, large scale. The assumption, so basically the trick here is that we assume that in any neighborhood within S, in a small neighborhood within S, the condition, because it's slow varying, we can assume there's a constant, infinite plane around that neighborhood, because in large scale can really scale, right? So a small local neighborhood, imagine that things are homogeneous and infinite on a plane. We can actually apply whatever formula, this is exactly the same formula on the last slide, but rather we put the x in.